Today we're going to talk about landslides.
For me, landslides are, well, a lot of dirt coming down off a hill. I guess you have a better explanation than I do for that.
Yeah, sure I do. So, I mean, in general, landslides are a gravitational process. And it's a gravitational process which is naturally occurring on Earth since the very beginning of it, and probably after we will be long gone. And it contributes to the evolution of our landscapes on a natural basis. Now, what the problem is that landslides now interact with the society we have built. And that's when the danger, when the called natural hazard, when the term natural hazard gets into place.
Okay, and what are the natural hazards then?
Natural hazard is any natural process that can harm us. So a flood, it's a natural process that normally, for example, you think about the Nile in Egypt, it was a way to bring nutrients to cultivate around, to do farming around it. But then nowadays, if we look at flooding now in cities that have sprawled around the basin of a river, then you can have that the river itself, when it floods, it causes a danger for us. And the same thing is for landslides as well.
Okay, so for landslides, why do we have them? What do they happen?
Why do they happen? So essentially, I mean, other than being a natural process that originates from a gravitational pull of the material, then you have slopes, because you need a slope, first of all. If it's flat, you don't have landslide by definition. But a slope, it's normally in a state of equilibrium. Okay, let's start like this. And then you may have some agents that will modify that equilibrium. For example, earthquake can shake the earth, and therefore they can reduce, for example, the cohesion, stability of a slope, or for example, reducing the friction along a sliding surface. And therefore you have this material hanging on a slope, which suddenly can loosen up and move downhill. Same thing goes for a rainfall event. When you have a lot of water pouring persistently over time and or impulsively over time, like in an extreme rainfall event, which are commonly unfortunate in this period due to climate change, you can have that water, for example, now lubricates a sliding surface and then makes it so that you have the equilibrium that was before there ceases to exist and the material moves downhill.
Okay, so one thing that I can imagine when this happens is that somebody lives on the bottom of the hill and that their house will be covered. What kind of thing can happen besides that?
I mean, a landslide for sure. I mean, let's take a step back and let's assume that landslide is just an umbrella term. Mm-hmm. So there are many gravitational processes that are referred to as landslide, though they behave in a radically different way. You can have topples on a cliff when you have some sort of cut at the base that the material can fall. Mm-hmm. You have rock falls. If you have a fractured rock with fractures that intersect each other, and then you have basically blocks of rocks that can easily be mobilized. Mm-hmm. You have debris flows, for example. These are type of processes where water is mixed with debris, so soil or rocks in a different proportion. And then you have the danger of this material moving fast downhill. So there are several other types, which I'm not going to discuss all of them. But basically, the danger of each one of them is for the material to then propagate and intersect our infrastructure. For example, you can have that a very deep-seated landslide can activate on a slope that was hosting a road, and therefore it will completely dislocate the road segment. Or you can have, again, a debris flow that can reach a city built close to the incision of a river, and therefore when the debris flow comes from above, then you can have danger for people living there. So two types of damage. Losses in terms of financial losses, mm-hmm. and losses in terms of human lives that can be lost.
Yep. And, your work here, what you do is modeling this and
yeah,
predicting.
So there are different ways to try to predict landslide, and there are different ways to actually tackle certain elements of a landslide. For example, if you want to model landslide velocities, how fast they travel, for example, that's not the type of modeling that I work on. Mm-hmm. This you need to, for example, solve the physics, the laws of physics behind a landslide activation. What I work mostly on is the use of artificial intelligence or statistical models to predict landslide occurrences over space, over time, and characteristics like their size.
Okay, and what do we try to do here? Let's say there's a lot of work in landslides and in natural hazards here at our institution, ITC.
So we have a super big group. Actually, in the last 4 or 5 years, we have hired, 4 professors that all work on landslides. So they're all in this floor. And what we tend to do is to combine, again, for example, artificial intelligence, physically based modeling. We combine also remote sensing and observation. So, for example, now there are satellites out there that, as the orbital frequency of the satellite illuminate the same site, mm-hmm. allows us to monitor whether the slope is moving or not. So there are various things that we can do. What I do is try to use an artificial intelligence, so a machine, to try to predict where landslide may occur in the future, again, when, and again, how large they may be.
Okay. Well, thank you very much.
Thanks a lot.
Do you want to be a GeoHero as well? Then take the first step and click the subscribe button and then the bell button to always be the first to know when one of our GeoHeroes posts a new video.